Okay, we're going to take a look at these razor sharp paper sharpening wheels. These are 8-inch diameter by 1¼ inches. You get two in the kit. They're about £50. I've had these for 2 or 3 years. Just thought I might just do a quick video just to sort of show these off in case you've never sort of come across these. They are very effective. So you get two wheels in the kit. You get one with like a fine grit, 180 grit wheel there, and the other one is just smooth. Now you do get in the kit some more grit in there if you want to sort of re-grit this wheel, which you would need to strip this off, apply glue, and then, you know, apply the grit to that. In use, you would keep this waxed up, but very light application of wax to that, and then you get like a rouge for the smooth side there. Perhaps a little bit too much on there. I just put some on before the video. So I'll just give you a quick demonstration. I've got a couple of knives here. They're only cheap trash knives that somebody just gave me to say, can you see if you can put an edge on those? So we're gonna have a go at these. We're not going dead exact with sorting out an exact 25 degree angle or anything like this. It's just going to be a case of get it on the wheel, get something that works, you know, roughly where we need to be. So I'll just give you a quick demonstration. They're not particularly sharp, these, so we're going to give these a polish up and see if we can improve the edges. So just a quick note on this is a buffer. You can actually get these wheels and fit them on a standard bench grinder very inexpensively. The only reason I went with a buffer is because they are further apart. The wheels will be further apart, and a bench grinder, they're generally a bit closer. So if you would, you know, doing a largish knife, then you'd be very close to the other wheel using a buffer. You're the further apart. So we'll get this going now, and we shall show you it in use. Okay. So we're round about this sort of angle. And the other thing to note is that I've reversed the direction of this. So basically I've taken the thing apart, lifted this top sort of motor off, spun it round, and fit it that way. That's why the label's at the back and the switches at the front. So safety glasses on. But the way this is, it's rotating away, so anything coming off this will go that way if this happens. Okay, so what we're actually looking for when we're using the grit side of the wheel is the production of a very fine, shiny sort of burr appearing on the edge of the knife there, and you should be able to just feel that. If I'm grinding that side, I should be able to feel the burr on this side, and vice versa. So we'll do this until such time that we get that burr. If you find that you're grinding and there's nothing appearing, what that probably means is you're too high up the wheel, and you're actually just sort of grinding the back of the edge and not the actual cutting portion. So we'll see how we go. And when you get to the tip of the blade on there, just be a little bit faster, because otherwise you'll overheat the tip. No burr as yet. Okay, now on that pass, I could just see the production of the burr forming there. So, and you're feeling for the burr all the way along the edge. That way you know that you've got consistent edge all the way along. And it's just a little bit, yeah, I've got that burr all the way along there now. Okay, so I'll give it one light flick on this side. See the burr being formed on that side as well. So I'm quite happy now that edge is complete on this wheel. Right, so we'll now move on to the polishing side. And what we're actually trying to do now is where we've got that burr on the edge. Just put that knife down. You can imagine that being the edge of the cutting edge there, and you've got like a very fine burr on the edge. What you want to be doing is to just polish that edge until that very fine burr just drops off, so you're left with just the neat edge. And you have to apply enough pressure, not heavy pressure, but enough pressure that you can actually, if you will, machine off that burr. If you're just tickling it, all you'll be doing is bending it backwards and forwards. Okay, and you can look down the edge of that, you'll be able to see if there's any of that burr remaining, and that looks pretty good, to be fair. Well, you can see that catching in the light there. Okay, so I'll get a piece of paper and we'll see how that actually cuts. Okay, so let's see what we've got. Okay, I think you'll appreciate that. That being pretty sharp, so if you got any decent knives, I'd certainly avoid the type of sort of pull through sharpeners that all it does is tear the edge of the knife, and it looks bloody awful. So you know, if you've got space to put up a little dedicated sort of knife sharpening sort of setup or rig in your garage, then you know, you can sharpen knives for your friends and family and what have you, but so, yeah, hope you found that useful.